First and foremost, the Pan-African Climate Justice Alliance, which is in short PAGJA, just celebrated 10th anniversary last year. And we came together as African civil society organizations, bringing together smallholder farmers, bringing together fisherfolk, forest communities, women, those small businesses, and many people. And the purpose of this, we realized that we did not have a voice in international discourse on climate change. You go to the COP, you find only 2 to 3 faces. Africa was really, really not represented, and that's the issue of procedural justice, which we have been talking about, that for you to be able to influence, you must participate and participate adequately and with relevant knowledge. So we did not have that. For 10 years, we believe that we have been able to achieve that. And our narrative is trying to see how the voices of those at the very bottom who do not have voice are given that voice so that they can be able to articulate it and shape those decisions, because the decisions we shape determine the future which we want. So we have been really lobbying. Now we have grown into a massive movement of around 1,500 organizations from 48 African countries. And don't ask me, what about the rest of 6 countries from Africa? The reason for that is really what we have been able trying to tackle, making climate change a governance issue. That in those countries, even the space of the civil society, the democratic space itself, is very limited. So there is even no way to reach out to the people there. And so this is what we have been trying to advocate for, ensuring broadened conversations around the issues which affect people, solution to climate change which do not affect the people at very local level, and ensuring that women, youth, indigenous people, and those people at the front line of climate crisis have a voice when we are in doing this debate, whether at national or international level. We apply various strategies. Of course, we work constructively with governments. What this means is that we talk as partners in this effort, bearing in mind that climate change requires unprecedented levels of cooperation, whether government and non-governmental, state and non-state actors, regions and regions, other regions in the world. There is no single country which can solve the climate crisis, including the most powerful, the United States. There is no individual who can solve the climate crisis. We need the cooperation among ourselves. There is no sector which can solve the climate crisis. We need all of us. There is no thematic area which can solve climate crisis. So you realize that we need to work, all of us, together, and that's why we encourage this. But if we realize that it is very difficult for governments, policymakers, to accept what we want and the voices of the people, then we apply what the civil society is known for. We use protests, processions, petitions, and many other tactics. And through this, we have realized that it is very effective, because if we want really to change people, particularly at civil society level, we need that to build the critical mass. And that is why we have been building at very local level, because governments are generally conservative. They will only listen to people if it makes political sense for them. And that's why the emerging movements of climate justice is very important. And various branches and levels of climate justice, particularly the emerging youth movement, which is really rocking the world. The Francis for the Future is like spontaneous movement emerging from inaction by policymakers, that the globe, the world, the planet is heating and heating, boiling and boiling, and yet the policymakers are living in their comfort and just making promises and promises. So these are some of the reactions which you can see. But my hope is that we are going to have a sustained campaign, that it is not going to be spontaneous. So one of the things which the Friends for the Future can learn is from Paja. It is just generating and keeping the movement, because climate change is not going to be solved by even by the current generation. So how then are we going to keep putting pressure through these evolving movements like Friends for the Future? And I believe that for 10 years, they have a lot to learn from Paja. We were written off for the first 3 years. We continued, and we continue to be now actually the most dominant movement on climate change. Not only climate change now, on all the issues. We are the top policy organization in Africa, and these have been demonstrated by the recognition we have achieved. I was named one of the most influential people on climate policy just in March by a global organization. We were recognized by the African Union as the top policy or environmental organization in Africa. So this is a demonstration that the building up and the tactics which we have really dominated the African space, and even other organizations are learning from us on how we need really to do the campaigns.